So you've probably come to this video exploring whether Superlist or Todoist is the best to-do list application for you. And today we're going to overview and give you a direct comparison between the two, looking at both of them and seeing which one is right for you. We're going to overview key features, information about the applications and pricing as well, so that you can go away with which to-do list application works best for you. Welcome everyone, my name is Francesca and welcome to Keep Productive. If you're new here, do subscribe, and if you're in the hunt for a productivity tool, maybe you want to dig a little bit deeper into Superlist or Todoist, then you could jump over to Tool Finder where you can find every productivity application. Now, you don't, at the end of this video, have to go with either one of these. You can scour our to-do list resources to find more, and if you're in the hunt for new productivity apps, then you can find the email newsletter below. Okay, so all the housekeeping is out of the way, let's begin. And in front of us, we have Todoist. Todoist has been in the market for over 10 years now, and it's been growing rapidly. More recently, it's introduced features like workspaces and calendar, and the application is really a traditional Todoist application that allows you to manage your tasks in projects, as well as board and calendar view more recently. This application is run by a company called Doist, who also create an asynchronous software called Twist, which has been also very popular on the market. And both of these applications are very much centric and well thought out in the productivity space, with a good reliability and general brilliance around the application. This is Superlist, and it's fairly new to the market, created by the folks that also built an app called Wunderlist, which was purchased by Microsoft back in the day. It has been in the works for several years now, but the application launched in February, at the start of February in 2024, and it's been growing rapidly since as a way to not only manage your tasks as a busy individual, but also as a team as well. And they're trying to find that, strike that balance between both teams and individuals managing their tasks. They have a way to manage your tasks in a list function that can also be used as almost an advanced note in the way that you can use it for meetings or planning a project, and it's very collaborative, allowing real-time collaboration. This application has been growing on the market and a lot of people have been liking it. You can watch our full Superlist first impressions feature below as well. So let's take a look at the interface and usability, and let's start with Superlist. Now, as you can see, it's very simply structured. You have an inbox, today, and messages, as well as tasks. Messages are where any task comes that you have been assigned or associated to that has a comment or something that might flag you in it. There's also an area for lists. Now, lists is really nice because you can not only tally some of your tasks up, you can personalize it with a background, but you can also make notes below, which allow you to collaborate a little bit further. Notes are even more extensive, allow you to add images, attachments, and dividers to break things up a little bit further. And that's really the tend to be the main feature inside of Superlist. But one thing, first off, the interface is really, really clean and much more minimal in comparison with Todoist, in my opinion. Whilst I would say usability, there are some small bugs like switching between certain apps. This is a really well-built to-do list application that is fast and easy to use. Jumping over to Todoist, you can see that it is very simple in nature. Maybe not as simple as the likes of Superlist, but you can organize your tasks in an inbox, today, and upcoming area for organizing what's ahead in your task list. There's also a way to view things in a board view for projects, which makes for planning out items. And more recently, they've added a way to view things in a calendar view. They do plan on adding expanding on their calendar view. And in general interface experience, this application has got considerably better over the last couple of years. And usability is probably one of the most stable to-do list applications on the market, in my opinion. So let's take a look at adding tasks and the whole realm of task management inside of both applications. Now, if you want to go ahead and create a task in something like Superlist, then you can go ahead and add an item. And what's nice about Superlist is there are some features that are really cool, like the ability to add all of the stuff that I showed you in lists, like headings, dividers and images, all inside of a subtask area, allowing you to expand on whatever you're doing there. So for example, here I've got heading 2 with loads of subtasks in there. And every time you create a subtask, it sort of spans out into a continual loop of additional tasks, which is actually quite nice and something you'll find in Todoist as well, but definitely really, really nice to have that ability to write notes below in a much more freeform fashion. Now, there's also an AI-based features that do separate in terms of task management, but there are some features like this in Todoist, allowing you to make with AI. But the one thing that I think separates it when it comes to task management is the ability to consolidate using integrations. Integrations allow you to collect up accounts like Gmail, Google Calendar, Microsoft To Do, and email forwarding, as well as for pro users, the likes of Slack, GitHub, Linear, and Figma, for connecting tasks and bringing them into Superlist so that you can consolidate them in one location. This is something you cannot do inside of Todoist. Whilst they have some Google Calendar integrations that is two-way, and some Gmail abilities, which is not technically a Gmail ability, it's a way to send tasks into a project. This is definitely a standout feature and is definitely something that a lot of pro users will tend to like. But largely, Superlist is a really neat way to start adding a task. You can plan a task ahead, even set reminders, which is free in the account, and organize your tasks quite simply. However, when it comes to task management and creating your own custom views, Todoist definitely has the leverage on Superlist. But largely, organizing them is quite easy to do, and filtering them is something you can manage as well. Now, I would say the killer feature in terms of task management is utilizing this area where you can organize your tasks a bit further. And some of the better ways that you can manage between some of your free accounts and toggling them off and on so that you can see the right and relevant areas and hiding them so that you're not distracted when you're working on certain projects. And this is a really nice feature that you can access inside of the team profiles, which are fairly reasonably priced at the moment. But largely, Superlist is really easy to get started with, and it's very basic in terms of some of the task management nature, but you can use the mobile applications to send in tasks and use the new task button in the bottom left-hand corner to be able to capture a task, as well as using it from the command bar shortcuts. So looking at task management inside of Todoist, whilst it's been around for a little bit longer, in the free plan, you aren't allowed to use reminders, which is something that I know a lot of people like when they're looking for a Todoist application. But largely, opening a task allows you to add it to a project and a due date and a priority level, which isn't available in the likes of Superlist. And you can add much more details to each of your tasks, which is available, like labels, reminders, which is a pro feature, both of these are pro features, and a location as well. Now, you can also add subtasks and, like in Superlist, go a little bit deeper into those tasks, but largely commenting is limited here. Those Superlist comments are really nice because you can send audio messages that are really simple to send and easy to do for team collaboration. Some of the things that stand out above Todoist over Superlist is the likes of Upcoming, which helps you to plan it in more of a board view, and Todoist have plans to add a calendar view, which is definitely ahead of the likes of Superlist at the current moment. Obviously, Superlist hasn't been around for a hideous amount of time, but at the same time, this is a really nice feature to have. You've already got project boards that allow you to manage stuff, and one of the features I think stands out above the likes of Superlist is views. So being able to view stuff in list, board, and calendar is very nice, but these filtering abilities are really good. For example, when you're in something like today, you can go super granular about what you sort, filter, and manage in terms of workspace, all the way to priority and all the relevant stuff as well, which is definitely something that a lot of people like when managing all of their tasks and details. They've really made a progressive progress as well to try and enhance team experience in Todoist with a more workspace brilliance or setup for the business plan. And I particularly like this. However, in comparison with Superlist, I think the way to hide it is not as good. Just looking at both of these head to head. In Superlist, you can hide a task or, for example, a full area that you're working on. For example, if I hid the tool finder area inside a Superlist, I wouldn't see it and therefore not distracting me. Whilst there are some features like this inside of the viewing options where you can manage between workspaces, this is definitely something you'd have to customize and narrow down to which area you want to, and switching between them would be something nice to get inside of Todoist. But largely, this framework of managing your tasks is really easy. The collaboration, I would say, is not as good as the likes of Superlist when it comes to sharing messages and comments, but largely, this is a much more robust task management platform. So taking a look at pricing, Superlist has an interesting pricing setup, and I will go to the monthly view, although there is a discount on annual. There is a free plan, which I believe to be one of the most generous on the market, even more generous, in my opinion, than the likes of Todoist, which includes unlimited tasks, notes, and reminders as well as some of the automatic email forwarding and integrations as well. There's even an email task summarization function, which I think stands out to compared to Todoist at the moment. But the Pro account, if you wanted it, unlocks unlimited shared lists with up to 25 people and some of the more advanced integrations as well. There's also up to 500 megabyte upload and 25 gigabyte file storage, which gives you a price of $10 per user per month. But if you're looking for a free plan for Teams, then up to 5 members can get access for it in totally free. But if you're looking to go monthly for unlimited team members per user, it's $12 per user per month. So if you compare this to the likes of Todoist, you do get some limitations when it comes to your free plan. And in my opinion, it's not too bad in terms of bringing in some of the more basic features, but you won't get access to things like task reminders. That is locked by a Pro account, which is $5 per user per month. But you do get a lot of functionality in that experience, including the brand new calendar layout. And that is $5 per user per month in comparison with Superlist's one, that is dramatically cheaper at 50% in comparison. And the business pricing is $8 per user per month with unlimited access unlocked. And of course, that's a monthly pricing, and the yearly pricing is slightly cheaper, a little bit like Superlist has as well. So both of these applications are very similar in nature. They want to help you to manage your to-do list and also get that team in. If you have a small team between maybe 5 and 25, to-do list applications can be a great system to be able to get things set up and manage your tasks. And to be honest, a lot of teams are moving away from project management applications because they don't want the density that these sort of applications have. So is this worth it for personal users? Todoist is a really reliable experience, and for personal users, works really, really well. The free account isn't hideously limited unless you want the reminders plan and that separation for work. The other thing that people do like to have is maybe the design element, which I believe Superlist does slightly better than Todoist. One of the other things that Superlist does very well at is the way to integrate stuff. Even in the free plan, there are some good ones. But I would typically recommend Superlist for those who don't want too much complexity in their task management experience, who want a clean and minimal design, and who want something that is going to get them going in their task management versus something that's very detailed in terms of its experience. The free plan is very generous, which will get you started very well. But Todoist is much more designed for a maybe advanced to-do list experience. Although I too, again, recommend it typically for pretty much anyone. For example, I could recommend it to my mother-in-law all the way over to a business professional for managing their own tasks. So at the same time, both of these applications are great for busy professionals. I think it comes in terms of preferences, especially when you look at features like natural language input, which Superlist don't actually have. Todoist has a functionality like that. So I think it's more between, if you're looking at Todoist, you're looking at a more robust, more powerful to-do list application, whereas Superlist much lighter with some other abilities that Todoist won't have in terms of the notes and other such functions. If you're looking at a team experience, I would say Todoist, again, has more views and more functions when it comes to managing tasks and viewing them in a different way. The combination of custom views and also the ability to organize your workspaces as well there is actually really, really good. And the upcoming calendar views will make things a lot easier. The pricing is also dramatically cheaper, probably per month around $4 per month per user cheaper. And when you have 15 people, that can work out to be a lot more per month, over £400 cheaper per month than the likes of something like Superlist. But Everyone who gets a Superlist team plan gets the pro plan for free. I'm not sure what the status is at with Todoist at the current time. However, largely, I'm impressed with how Superlist have brought together their team experience. So I would say for teams, if you're looking at it, Superlist is probably a good option if you're a creative, visual, and a team that makes lots of different notes. It's also great for smaller teams with a generous free plan for 5 people. But largely, if you're looking for something much more robust and more custom viewing options, then I would go with something like Todoist. So folks, hopefully this overview gave you some insights about whether to pick Todoist or Superlist. Please let us know in the comments below with what you go with. And if you do decide to go with one of them and you do enjoy it, feel free to share a review over on Toolfinder. You can give insights on what your experience is like, and that's really important to helping other people make decisions. So if you are in a hunt for productivity tools after this, or you want to explore more Todoist applications, jump over to Toolfinder and I'll help you find any of them there. So thank you very much, folks, and I'll see you all very soon. Do subscribe and have a fantastic day ahead.